I'm Nelson Jaffrey, Head of Design at Birla Cellulose, and welcome to the first of our three series webcast. Well, COVID-19 has changed life as we know it. Disruption has become the new normality as people adapt to working from home. Most businesses are still under closed doors and a default state of social and economic anxiety prevails. 2020 will define the future of fashion. This is not a crisis, but we can sell our way out of, but we need to be careful and design our way through it with thoughtful products. Well, over the next few days, we will be bringing designers across India to start a conversation on what is the future of fashion amidst this COVID-19 crisis, how we can rebuild this industry, which we love so much, and help our partners navigate through the situation around. And today, I'm extremely delighted to have with me the extremely creative, talented designer and a dear friend, Sahil Kocher. He's based out of Delhi, and Sahil Kocher owns a niche prêt-à-couture luxury brand specializing in unconventional textures and embroideries. His creations are fresh and contemporary, inspired by the rich cultural heritage of India and the artistry of our craftsmen. His intricate treatment highlights his innovative approach to material and craftsmanship. Sahil graduated from the National Institute of Fashion Technology in 2006 and, being acclaimed for the Most Creative Collection Award, started working with one of India's greatest designers, Rohit Bal. He started his own label in 2013. His vision is to cater to a global audience by creating a combination of all things that are essentially Indian, yet bringing them up to speed with all the modern trends. Sahil, welcome to our webcast and thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Nelson. Those are such kind, sweet words and nice words said, you know, said by you. And I'm happy to join, and hi to everyone who's online with us.
Great. Sahil, let's begin our conversation. Firstly, very importantly, the one question that comes to one's mind is, how has the fashion industry been affected by the coronavirus?
Well, it's been affected very adversely, actually. The thing is that, you know, everything is at a standstill. Almost everyone was working on orders on stuff which, you know, were in process. They're now completely, you know, on hold. A lot of export has stopped. We personally had some orders from Middle East, which, you know, we could not send. And as you know, the biggest festival that they have is Eid, you know, so they expect their deliveries before Eid now. So all of that is on standstill. And, you know, other than that, most importantly, I think the fact is that, you know, a lot of, you know, people who work for us, they're not from cities, they're not from Delhi or, you know, places like Noida, Gurgaon, where our, you know, workshops are. So for them, it's obviously, you know, scary. This whole corona, you know, COVID-19 thing is very scary for all of us. Imagine what they are going through. So, you know, I am in touch with almost everyone from my team. So it, you know, it is very difficult for them to go back and, you know, to manage everything. A lot of places where they stay, it's been quarantined and it's been, you know, contaminated, but they come under contaminated zone. So it's very difficult for them to move around to, you know, make necessary everyday arrangements for them. Whatever help we can make or provide, we are doing that. But I don't think that's enough, you know. It has somehow, we'll have to kind of ease out things for them, for everything, you know, for them to be more comfortable, which is not currently happening.
Okay, yeah, no, we definitely understand this has been quite an impact to the industry. And also, I would like to know, Sahil, due to the sudden lockdown imposition, most of the current season's clothing would not have been sold yet. Do you think the same collection could be reoffered to customers post-lockdown, or is it necessary to introduce a new collection for a new season?
So I think what would be better or a smarter way to deal with this would be, like, for example, you have your collection ready. You take the collection forward. You obviously can't sell all, you know, everything from that collection to in the next season. What you can do is you can infuse it with some new pieces, some new colors, make a combination of the two seasons, just add a few more pieces so that it looks more complete and can sit well with autumn winter also. But making a completely new collection, I don't think is viable. I don't think anyone would be doing that. I just feel that it's smarter and easier to just add a few more pieces and make it more viable to sell it in the coming season.
And particularly in terms of your business, what has been your learnings, you know, during these challenging times?
In terms of, as in, if you can please.
In terms of your business, I mean, how do you think, you know, did you have any learnings that were new to you, you know, during these challenging times?
See, the thing is that, you know, one thing that we have learned is, actually, before getting there, I will say that, you know, before this COVID-19 happened, we were already in process of, you know, getting or employing people which were working in villages, getting their art and craft and guiding them what they can do, you know, for us. Because as I told you, we have started working more on couture and bridal. So we're trying to, you know, get in touch with people in Bareilly, we get in touch with people in Farukabad and all these places so that, you know, they can work for us, we can give them more work. So I think what I've learned now also is the fact that this is the way forward. What you will have to do is I think as a brand, you will have to have smaller units all over. Maybe even if they're not your own units, but you're providing work to them, and then, you know, everything has to be more virtual now. Even your sampling apps, you know, one will need to do virtual sampling. Like, you will have to get in touch with people who are maybe, you know, miles, 100 miles, 1,000 miles away from you. You will have to be in touch with them. Everyone has WhatsApp, everyone has video call now. So, you know, you have to kind of guide them, tell them what to do, what not to do, show them your things that you like, show them the swatches that you've done, show them the work that you've done, and they'll kind of develop on that. This is what I have kind of learned, and I also thought about it, because this is not going to be easy. We can't, even if, you know, the things are relaxed, this is not going to go away. It's not going away. We like the hot word right now is that you'll have to, you know, learn to live with it. That's what everyone is saying. Once before the vaccine, they hit the stove. So you have to work during this time. We are already in touch with people who can start working from their home, you know, who have the families who do this work, and they have two or three people working. We have already in touch with them. What we're planning to do is we're planning to send them, courier them fabrics and stuff so that they can start sampling for us, and they can start making proper full outfits with us. As soon as we start work, we'll send them more and more stuff to do. So this, and also one thing that we as a brand were very weak with was social media marketing. So all I've been doing during this quarantine time is reading, attending webinars, learning more what we can do so that, you know, we can kind of move forward in that direction and do some better for ourselves.
Also, for the past 2 months, most of us, you know, have been living out of our pajamas, and we have seen new trends emerging as a result of this lockdown, like, you know, hashtag stay home style, above the keyboard dressing, slouch, home hub, etc. Do you think these kind of trends will be a part of fashion even post the lockdown?
Even post lockdown? I think post lockdown it's going to get reduced a little, but it still might be there, but much lesser than what it is right now, because right now, you know, it's more of you know, something that everyone's wanting to share and kind of a statement saying, yeah, you know. But after, once it opens, it's going to, you know, like people who have like really big organizations, I think what they're going to do is they're going to have alternate day working. And they're probably also going to do, some people will work from home, some people will go to office, and all of this is going to happen. So it's going to reduce is what I think. But yeah, it's going to stay with us for a bit.
It seems people have been spending a lot of time online, you know, these days. And surely most of them have become more techno savvy. Does this mean the fashion industry has to focus on the online and the virtual front more than before now?
Completely. Completely, they'll have to, because any which ways, you know, online was and is a big thing. You know, you can't ignore it. And after this, I think it's just going to go on a different level altogether. It's going to, you know, get a big boost because of the fact that people would prefer buying more online, people. And also, it's not about prefer. Now, everyone has to be more tech savvy. You know, everyone's learning how to operate things with people who had no clue about going online, how to shop. They're kind of learning, they're getting, you know, more privy with the social media scenario, and, you know, they're getting to learn more of it. So I think obviously it's going to affect, and the increase is going to be more in terms of online digital sales as compared to brick and mortar.
Okay, and the uncertainty around the COVID-19 pandemic has forced most of the consumers to slow down and spend more time at home, leading to a prioritization and more comfort dressing, you know. And as we are adjusting to, you know, this cocooning, and so what we are putting next to our skin is becoming more important. Sahil, you have worked with Liva Fabrics before. Considering this, do you think it can be a preferred choice of fabric?
I think it can also, because not only because of the fact that they want comfortable clothes. Yes, Liva as you know, as fabrics are very kind of very nice, drape has good great fall and is very comfortable. That obviously goes without saying. But other than that, also people are becoming more aware of the fact that, you know, it's more, or you know, you follow certain steps and measures which are more sustainable. And like, for example, if I'm not wrong, that you grow more trees than cutting because it's made out of wood pulp. So all of these things are going to, you know, people are going to realize the fact that it's more about respecting the environment and the people around it than rather, you know, going for fast fashion where you're using cheaper sources, you're using cheaper fabrics, and it's not helping anyone. You know, you need to have something which stays with you, which is comfortable, and which you can, you know, down the year also pull out and see, you know, you can still wear it. It's not, you know, fast. I think it's going to be more of fashion, which is now going forward is going to be, you know, which has a thought behind it, which is more sustainable, which is more organic. I think, and the best part about Liva is that it really checks in all those boxes, the fabric, the textile that you guys make.
Yes. You know, these days we see a lot of masks, you know, being produced, manufactured and being marketed. Do you see this becoming a fashion statement? You know, many celebrities have also endorsed such dressing styles. And you being in the bridal wear business now, do you think this will become a part of or become a must-have accessory, considering a lot of, you know, weddings that is going to come up post the lockdown?
I think mask and, you know, good mask is already a statement. You know, I don't think it's going to be a statement. It already is what I feel. Yes. And I'm not sure about the bridal market though. But generally, if you see, I think it is a statement, because I've seen a lot of brands have already, you know, with the outfits, they've started dispatching matching masks. And they making of the same fabric that you're using for the garment. They've, you know, started making the same fabric mask for them. So I think it already is a statement, and people are kind of, you know, making sure that even the mask is used as an accessory or as a style statement rather than just, you know, protecting themselves. Obviously, a mask will protect by the end of the day, but it needs to be more cool, funky, and more of a statement than just an, you know, a utility.
Sahil, we recently conducted a study, and most consumers are inclined towards need-based shopping, you know, only based on occasions. What impact do you think this could have on the industry? Do you think or see a shift from the traditional spring, summer, autumn, winter seasonality to a more, you know, festive, focused or only occasional shopping?
You know, it's very difficult to kind of anticipate that or read that right now. But I initially for some time that might be the case, but I don't think it's going to stay for long, because you know, eventually, as you said, people are going to shop more for occasions. But out in India, there are just too many occasions. We love to have an occasion for every other thing. So it is going to bounce back. People are going to start buying more, and they will find occasions. We will find occasions. We will find things. We want to go for a lunch. We want to meet a friend. That is an occasion for us, you know. So initially, because, you know, everyone's just kind of had this very bad setback, and you know, we are trying to cope up with this whole scenario, so it seems like, you know, boss, who's going to think about shopping right now? But slowly, gradually, things are easing out, and I think we'll all bounce back and we'll go back to the normal pattern.
Also, you know, there's been a lot of education about the impact of fashion on the environment, and a lot of influencers promoting, you know, reduce, reuse, upcycling kind of culture. Do you see this influencing fashion even post COVID? And will consumers be willing to adopt these practices? And will the post-COVID world see the end of fast fashion? I think we already discussed on this little, you know, a bit ahead. But what do you think? I mean, is there a future for fast fashion? Will that end, or will consumers be more mindful towards sustainable shopping?
I think consumers will be more mindful. And I also think, you know, because everyone has got this time to become more aware of what is happening, how are things made, what are the practices that the brands are following. I think now everyone is more interested about the fact that, you know, how in whatever small way they can probably give back to the environment, or probably help, you know, help the environment in a way that they're not harming it. So, and it starts from us. We also, as brands and as influencers, you said that, you know, online influencers, if they put this information out, if we market it well, then I'm sure there'll be a big shift in this. And as far as fast fashion, you know, goes, like we discussed earlier, I feel it also, you know, it also comes on the brands that who are actually producing fast fashion, who are making, who are mass producing. They should also kind of now understand the need of the hour and make sure that whatever they're using, whatever processes they are following, they are more environmental friendly and more sustainable. Once they start doing this, you know, it's going to be the norm. So, you know, more or less everyone from top to bottom is going to be following it. There'll be more awareness about it. So, you know, you'll automatically want to go for something which is more sustainable, which is more environmental friendly, is what I feel.
Yes, definitely. I think sustainability is the way forward in fashion.
And a lot of people are putting a lot of efforts also. Like I've heard that there was this denim factory who, because, you know, you would definitely know that denim takes a lot of water.
Water, yeah. It's
going to be a big thing. So people who start investing in it now are going to make a big change later when you see these things in future.
Definitely. Also, a lot of our consumers have responded saying that, they are not willing to shop for the next 2-3 months. Will we see a huge discount wave coming in from brands, you know, to push out existing inventory that's in stock due to this lockdown?
I think it's going to be more in respect to the fast fashion category than as compared to, you know, the designer, the niche market that we're talking about. And because, you know, it's about mass places where there's mass production, right? They have thousands and tens of thousands of pieces lying with them. They'll end up putting almost everything on discount. But what I read online also is the fact that, you know, they're trying to not put everything on discount, maybe carry this stock forward, like I said earlier, add a few more pieces, like add jackets and stuff to the already collection lying with them, so that it can, you know, transcend from one season to the next.
Sahil, what are the kind of innovations that we can expect from the fashion industry? With so much of safety and healthcare being concerned among the consumers, do you think designers will see these influencing fashion in any way?
See, there's no end to innovation, right? It's about how can you implement a particular invention into the kind of range or the kind of fashion that you do. Like, for example, the other day when I was online, I was researching, I was thinking, what if, you know, you develop a fabric, and I was actually researching for gloves, which is not related to fashion, but, you know, which can also be interpreted in fashion in a different way. I was thinking, what if you have a glove which has an outer layer of some molecule which has been kind of infused in a fabric, and as soon as the virus gets in touch with it, it actually gets deactivated, or it gets, you know, dissolved in it. Like, for example, alcohol kills it, right? So that's why we sanitize it. That's why we sanitize our hands, because if we have a virus on our hands and we put alcohol, it's going to. So imagine if the same kind of scenario or some kind of technology or some kind of innovation has been put into gloves, where the outer layer is such a material, like silver does it, but silver is too expensive. You know, you can't have gloves with silver kind of mesh or things in it. So we'll have to, all of us have to kind of be more innovative, but it can be in many different areas. I'm sure like yours also, you're already working, like Liva would be already working on certain specific fabrics which are more exactly. Kind of, you know, which are more innovative, which are something, you know, which the market needs going forward.
Definitely, Sahil. Here I would like to add that Liva has, you know, recently introduced antibacterial fiber.
Exactly.
So, you know, we have done our trials and everything, and I will definitely share the entire write-up with you. And this is something maybe the fashion industry could also absorb in the near future.
Exactly. So we need such stuff so that we can both sit together and make some, you know, a new collection of to make fashion which is more sensible.
Yeah. Moving forward, Sahil, anything like that you would like to share? How you have changed your way of working or your operations, you know, now since you have opened up post-COVID? Is there anything that has changed completely what it was before?
So I had this very bad habit of mine to be in office, always monitoring everything, checking everything. So now I've learned you need to give some space. So if it's social distancing, you need to give space over there also. And you need to allow your team and your designers to take that self-initiative. So what we are doing is, like I said earlier, it's going to be more of virtual sampling. Now, in fact, I want to go to an extent where, you know, I give like a small place to a designer with few people to do sampling with, and everything is monitored on, you know, through a video conference or something, or through a video call where we check everything, where I give all my inputs through a video call, where I see things through a camera or something, and I keep telling them, and they adapt to it and they learn. The moment they learn all of this and they adapt to what I'm telling them, then I'll build more trust on them. So it's an exercise, but you know, it is a very useful exercise to train your people. Once they know, once they understand what you're wanting to do or what I expect out of them, then they're obviously going to deliver as per my expectation and as per my likings. So I think, yeah, this is one big change that I have already applied. Like I'm also trying to break the processes. One of my designers is constantly working on silhouettes. She's sketching. The other designer is always working on some swatches. Everything's happening virtually more or less.
Okay. And Sahil, we were just discussing, you know, a question came to my mind about this antibacterial fiber. Do you think having any technical or functional property introduced into a fashion line, does this bring the fashion quotient down, or that's okay?
No, why would it bring it down? I don't think so. I don't think it's going to bring it down. In fact, if we are able to put the message across nicely and it's marketed well, I think it's going to only take it up and make it more, yeah, make it more, you know, kind of useful fashion.
And also, I think how it is marketed, you know, to the consumers, I mean, make them understand what lies behind.
Which is very important. And now with this social media boom, I think if we are able to do it nicely, it can actually travel.
I'm sure you could. Yeah. Sahil, moving forward, we have more like a rapid fire round, but don't worry. I'm just kidding. It gets closer to that, but of course, without any gift hampers. So I have a few options here though. So with retail stores shut down and inventory stuck in transit or in storages, which marketing strategy do you recommend best to clear stocks once, you know, outlets open? Declare, you know, irresistible offers on e-commerce platforms and don't wait for the stores to open, or declare discounts in showrooms once the stores open. People will anyway like to come up out and shop at showrooms. Or do you think both of the above?
Both of the above, if you're offering discounts.
Okay. What will be the impact in the seasonal cycles in fashion? Will it stay the same, or will there be longer season cycles, or seasonless dressing will take over with long-lasting wardrobes?
Personally, it should be long-lasting wardrobes. And as far as India is concerned, I think fashion, you know, our winters is not literally like winters, you know. We can still kind of, if you put in some summer clothes and put a jacket on top, and we can live with it. So I think it, personally, longer wardrobe and longer stitch.
Yeah. So what kind of trends do you think will pick up now? Do you see a shift more towards sustainability? Mm-hmm. Will fast fashion take a backseat? Mm-hmm. Will there be a lot of virtual collection unveiling, you know, now since we don't have fashion weeks? So will there be a lot of virtual collections which will be unveiled, you know, online? Or do you see a rise in comfortable fashion for virtual meetings since one won't be traveling that much?
I think option 3 and 4, more virtual collection and comfortable
fashion. Great. Also, what do you think Indian consumers would do post the lockdown? You know, and once things open, will they take to shopping immediately? Or will it be more of an online trial and error shopping? Will they wait till the festive wedding season to buy clothes, or wait for this whole pandemic to end completely and then venture out shopping?
No, I think they'll start shopping. I somehow feel they'll all start shopping. The only thing is, the restrictions should be more eased out. If you have, if a gathering, a little bigger gathering is allowed, then they'll all be out and they'll start shooting. After the pandemic is over and the vaccine is out, you just wait and watch what is going to happen.
Great. Okay, Sahil, on that note, we would like to end this session, and thank you so much for joining us, and sharing your views and thoughts. Extremely happy to have you here. And thank you for the session. Yeah.